Come on, RJ. Let's see the tour of my room. This is my vintage suitcase with some accessories and a great People magazine. My great bed with curtains, my rock star poster. And then I also have a poster of Lady Gaga and Justin Bieber. I love Justin Bieber.
Why would you love Justin Bieber? All he does is flick his hair every 24/7.
My green chair. I also have a Webster's Dictionary. As you can see, my parents got me a college fund piggy bank. They have very high expectations. I have some cards, The Secret of the Old Clock Book, and some bubble gum. We can chew that later. And all these books on iguanas. Do you know? We're going to be studying our butts off. Of course, we have my chair, my new tech 3G computer that I got for Christmas. All my supplies. Of course, I got to have a frame, my flowers, my light. And my digital 3D phone. Well, now you've seen the tour of my room, we need to get our study on.
Don't forget your 3D decoder.
Oh yeah, we'll need that later. Hey, I have an idea. Why don't we do a KWL chart? So, K
for what we know.
W
for what we want to know.
And L
for what we want to learn.
That's pretty good. Okay, so first, what do we know? Oh, we know Spike is an iguana that destroyed a volcano project looking for food.
How do you spell iguana?
You spell it I-G-U-A-N-A. Okay, the next one should be, a ping pong ball was found in the volcano cake. Why would a ping pong ball be in a volcano cake? You ready for the next one?
Mm-mm. Now what else do we know?
Well, we also know that there may be a connection between iguanas and ping pong balls. But why would there be? Guess we'll just have to read. Our KWL chart's looking pretty good.
Now, what do we want to know?
We want to know facts about iguanas.
Maybe we could do facts about ping pong.
That sounds pretty good, RJ. Hey, do iguanas and ping pong balls have anything in common? Hey, why don't we put that down for what we want to know? Well, we're done with our KWL chart. Since we have done our KWL chart, we need to start studying. Okay, so now that we've done our KWL chart, we should divide and conquer our work. Since I already got some books at the library about iguanas, I think I should do iguanas.
Okay, then I'll get ping pong.
That is perfect, because I got you a book, Ping Pong for Dummies. It so matches your personality.
I got the perfect book for you, too. Iguanas for Dummies, just like you.
Okay, so now that we have everything organized, I'm going to go email the teacher and tell her that we've got everything under control and organized. Great, the teacher sent us an email. The next clue, it's K.
I think the first word is spike.
RJ, that's the smartest thing you've ever said. What did you learn in the book I got you? Ping Pong for Dummies.
I learned this great ping pong trick on YouTube. Look, I could make it a ping pong ball levitate.
Seriously, RJ, we've been studying for 2 hours straight, research and hard work, and all you've learned is how to levitate a ping pong ball.
Okay, I learned that ping pong balls are white and round. What have you learned?
Well, I learned a bunch of stuff by reading those books, and I made flashcards. Well, I'm gonna email the teacher and tell her that we studied and that we communicated.
At least I did.
Great. The teacher sent us an email. She gave us 2 more letters. It's E and I. So we know the first word is spike, but what could the second word be? Okay, RJ, I'm gonna call my dad so he can help us with our studying. Dad, can you help us with our studying?
Okay, coming, dear. What do you have for us?
Some flashcards about iguanas.
Oh, great, flashcards. Flashcards are a great memory resource to help you reinforce your memory. It's an age-old trick. Hey, RJ, how are you?
Good.
I knew your dad, Roy G. Biv. He was funny.
What's funny is he's not even funny.
Oh, well, I still knew your dad. Okay, well, let's see. It looks like you've been studying with flashcards about iguanas, right?
Mm-hmm.
Okay, here's a few flashcard questions for you. Just tell me who knows the answer. How long can a green iguana grow?
6 feet.
Great. What can an iguana grow back if it breaks?
Its tail.
That's true. How do iguanas reproduce?
They bury their eggs in the dirt.
Exactly. And how many eggs can an iguana lay?
10 to 50.
That's right. And how long can an iguana hold its breath?
30 minutes.
That's perfect. And what do natives call iguanas?
Bamboo chickens.
Bamboo chickens. Exactly. Great way to remember it. What does an iguana egg look like?
It's creamy, white, and round.
Almost oblong. Perfect. Now, iguanas are omnivorous. Do you know what that means?
They mostly eat plants, but they also eat insects.
Great. Well, that's all the flashcards I have. Looks like you're going to do perfect, hon.
Okay.
I'm going to get back to the ball game.
Okay, Dad.
Bye, RJ. Tell your dad I said hi.
Okay.
Okay, RJ. I'm going to email the teacher and tell him that we have done 7, the memory trick. Great. He just sent us the next letter. It's S. So, what it's spelled so far is spike is.
Hmm.
That sounds weird.